little calf. Hello there.
Anyhow, hey guys. So this came out yesterday, and as soon like I was preparing a live stream for All Guardsmen Party, the last episode before today's that I checked out, and this popped up. That's why I advanced everything about 20 minutes forward. So we're live, and what we're gonna be doing is checking out Something Is Wrong with Horse, and I need a billboard about the size of the state of Wyoming that says I see what you did there, because I already see what's gonna be happening. Yes. Okay. So, a couple of things quick. I'm gonna be editing most of the night tonight. Five-ish minute lore, the final episode for Dantioch and Alexis Pollux, is going to be coming out on Patreon hopefully tomorrow morning. And it is just, I already know who I'm doing next. I'm just gonna have fun with it. Yes. You know what? The old man lives thing, it was like, I loved that. And it was all, never mind. I'm getting like 17 different ways. Iron Kiko is here. Hi, Iron. Jackson is here. Jacob Finley's here. Chris K is here. Super Saiyan Diclonius is here. Super Saiyan Diclonius. Me and him talked a little bit, and I'm going to be reading something that he put together, and I really can't wait to have time to do that. I literally went to sleep about an hour after I got done with the live stream a little bit ago. Let's see. The Golden Tech Maroop is here. Warden's here. Ronnie's here. Let's see. Did I get everybody? Slacker's here. The Hobbit is here. Jacob Finley is here. And Sothasil is here. Sothasil, yes. Octationally Funny is here. Dark Innovator. I'm sorry, Dark Innovator. Dark, I know this is late for you, but I know. And yes, the Puggos are in the background. What's up, Richard? And hey, Hitman. All right, so I anticipate this is gonna jump up kind of rapidly. Last time I did anything with Hunter the Parenting, we had about 100 people in, and so I'm gonna give like a little bit of time for people to kind of like come in, sit down. Once again, just saying, this is a live stream reaction. If you clicked on this within a day of me actually posting it, live chat might not actually be ready yet. The video has to finish processing, then live chat comes up. Yeah, Carlos, I didn't expect this to come. I wanted to check out two episodes of Guardsman Party, and then that would be it for my live streams for this weekend, because I intended to be recording right now. And well, I'm not gonna not check out something by Bruva, Alfabusa. All right, so Richard Johnson's here making pork chops and mac and cheese. Richard, have you ever there's just one seasoning and maple syrup. Trust a fat guy. We know how to cook. Yeah, Dark, I'm nocturnal by nature anyway. That's why the job I have, it's perfect for me. Currently watering my neighbor's plants. It's going to be blistering hot tomorrow. Yeah, I know, bud. I know. All right, so it is time for the horse heresy. I mean, something is wrong with horse. All right, here we go. Look at that walk. Your Varela, what's up, bud? Did anyone else catch that? That was Down with the Sickness. No, that was not Down with the Sickness. That was a corn song. Something. Freak on a Leash. Oh my god, really? Really?
Sweetest boy! Horse! Let me see you, my son. Oh, my sweet darling son child, I'm so sorry you aren't feeling good. Oh, I've no idea whence this affliction came, but I promise you, I shall help you overcome it. Now, time for my lovely, lovely son to get his medicine. There you go. Gulp it down. There'll be no more horse plague in this household. Just like last time. That's a good son, a very good son. Yes, he is. Yes, he is.
Oh.
All right. Let's get you comfortable and ready for beddy bye. Now, you'll need all these blankets to keep warm, my son. To help the humors digest the medicine.
Yeah.
Here's your...
Thank you, Slacker. Have I ever played Resident Evil? No. I think I played Resident Evil 1, and that was it. That was the only one I ever actually played. Mr. Reich, yes, you got here just in time. I just started it. If Horse lived this long with Big D, then the dude is doing something right.
You agree with me across you, but now you recall our agreement. Me, get to shower you in physical affection and worldly possessions, while Horse, you, get to hear my every woe and finally let me speak my mind. So let us begin. I am now sitting down. Now, my dearest Horse, it's become very apparent that my other sons seem incapable of even the simplest cognitive feat, those poo-poo silly baby heads. Take the deodorant, for instance. Marcus goes and does something utterly senseless, and then proceeds to go like, how could I have known? Like he couldn't have put two and two together. That boy did not pay attention during the math class I taught in Swomi. A vampire eating another vampire obviously results in one double vampire. He was supposed to know this without me having to babysit his brain. And he wasn't supposed to be doing something like that in the first place.
True.
He was supposed to interrogate and experiment, not gleefully commit war crimes.
But good times rhymes with war crimes.
An experiment. In any case, his curiosity goes far beyond what I wanted. If he wanted to torture them, he could have kept it to Mario Party. My trust has been broken, not his. And what's more, ever since, he's been heckling me with question upon question about Diablery. Why do they not understand the danger such knowledge brings to them? Do they not trust me? Why shouldn't they? I tell them absolutely everything they would ever need to know and nothing else. It's for their own good, Horse. You should know this too. I keep things from you as well. Oh, but it's not like I don't trust any of you.
Oh my especially
god. Especially you, my dearest Horse. It's just, if I told you all my secrets, your giant brains would implode from the weight, and you'd be hunting for sports in the filthy streets of Norfolk. Or worse, Ipswich. And yet... No.
No.
That's not entirely it, is it? Why neglect you, Horse? Why do I keep the deep secrets of my vaunted memory vaults from others? Especially you, children who have not betrayed me.
Oh, good God.
Is it truly because this knowledge is too dangerous to be shared? Is it because I want to protect you, and the only way I know how is to keep you ignorant and placid? By creating a self-cannibalizing Ouroboros, where you fail to meet my expectations when confronted with trials that you could have overcome if I had just given you the much-needed information.
The parallels here are just painful.
What if I did fully bring you into the light? What would you do with the real truth, Horse? Would you die horribly to the things hiding in the dark?
Yeah, Mr. Reich, this sounds really familiar.
Far more sinister ways. Or might things actually turn out for the better? Could they? Or... would this action only serve... fucking ass bearers. Sir Caracas, please be quiet. I'm talking to my horse. Well, that has completely ruined my train of thought. Neighbors, how I loathe the concept. What the fuck was I saying, horse? All right. What about tourist trips from the top of the Algonquin Club? Now let me set the scene. New York, 1882. The Frasafin had just been invented. And under the silver lace ceiling from the top floor of the Algonquin Club, two swingers by the name of Dietrich Titella and Horse were cutting up some fucking rug. Dietrich had the sweet honey on his waist, while Horse was heading deep in some of that good spinach shit. Dietrich was about to make some new social security number with his honey. Before he could get any further, the fucking fuzz showed up and started the raid on the speakeasy, so we had to cut more rug. So I hopped onto Horse, and we made our way to the parking lot. Thankfully, our ride was impounded there. When I got there, I strapped Horse to the bottom of the bus and I gunned it. And there it was, just utter nonsense of hopping state lines and making some new ones, eh, Horse? Hey. Yeah, you remember it. Your brain is humongous. But rest now.
My brain hurts. It hurts.
Oh, my boy. Papa's here. Good.
There's Kitten.
Big lad.
Sir D.
Shh, son. What is it?
It's time to change your bandages, and I don't think it's sanitary for you to be sleeping with horse.
Nonsense! Horses groom daily, and microbial infections only affect evil people!
I still really don't think you should be out here, though. Horse is sick, after all, and he's been coughing up a lot of
blood. I said I am not going fucking insane! Shh, horse. Shh. Oh, calm down. I will go inside, if and only if you stay out here with him for the rest of the night. The other boy is always jealous of the fact that I bought actual shampoo for horse.
You did?
Yes!
The 99p shop?
No, on the black market. Same place I get all my Herculoid alkaloids.
Oh my God.
Have you bought a new blender yet?
No. But, all right. I'll stay with him until the morning, I guess?
Capital old sport. Now be sure to feed him medicine every few seconds or he won't get better. Oh, and make sure to keep him warm with a blanket.
Yes,
and...
sir, I understand. And,
and
I can...
make sure to feed him the apples I bought.
I will.
Good night, horse. Just scream very loudly if you need daddy again, okay? Bye-bye.
All right.
I would like to know the dimensions, weight in kilograms and pounds, and general atomic hardness of whatever hit Big D in the head to cause him to act this way.
And don't forget to refill his water if he gets thirsty!
I get it!
Please remember to give him a head pat before he sleeps again.
Yes, sir.
Okay, goodbye, I love you, horse. Tell him lots of stories, son in law. He loves them!
Holy Toledo.
Like, he has the Vince McMahon walk. Look at him. He's full out strutting on his way. And the umbrella hat is really working on him.
Well,
that's the Master Mankind, people.
Horse! Mate. How you doing? Oh, no. Right, okay. Let's get you some of this medicine. For coughing, internal bleeding, receding hell. Holy shit, 800 quid?! Where does he find the money? Who am I kidding? He didn't pay for this. Alright, horse. Open up. Now, Sir D wanted me to keep you company. So, what's your story, actually? I've heard, like, 7 different accounts from multiple people as to where you came from. Marcus once said Sir D inherited you from one of his mums or dads. Whatever that means. But Sir D himself is pretty cavalier about it. I think he once implied you burst out of his skull like a Athena. But that might have just been modern mythology in the making.
Hey, Jake, I'm glad you had a good birthday, bud.
Right, sorry. Well, I guess the most likely story is Remold's. The old grouch. He always claimed you were stolen from an old lady near Horsey Beach.
Really? But Horsey Beach?
Honestly, I'm pretty sure he thought D was the devil even before he got banned from the Arcanum, so I don't know.
Okay, seriously, Horse was once in charge of the Luna Hooves? Jackson, you didn't need to say that. That pun was just... That was unbearable.
Ah, shit, I'm sorry, you're not looking too good. I think it's fine to give you a second dose. Man, what even is this stuff? Ah, well. Open wide, Horse. Here comes the train. Ow! That is a lot of blood all over me. Just stay there, Horse. I need to... Shit. Fuck. Marcus, could you come out to the horse's house?
What? Why?
He coughed blood over me and I'm soaked in it.
Can't you just leave him alone for a second and change?
I can't. Sir D said that he needs to be watched.
Forget what father said, just come back inside. Horse is
Marcus,
dying.
Please, the horse is dying.
Was that Kraken?
Please come out now.
Okay, fine, I'm coming out.
Dang it. This is one of my favorite jumpers. I hope I can get...
Motherfucker, it's your only jumper.
Get this blood out. Oh, it's so thick. The medicine is everywhere. Oh, Horse. Oh, little guy.
Oh my god.
I can't stay mad at you, no matter how horrifically disgusting you are. Marcus will be here soon, and I'll see if I can find the other bottles when I'm back.
Horse damn well better be dying,
companion. Oh, shit, you.
He called him companion.
Yeah. Just stay with him for a bit. I need to go back inside.
What the hell happened?
I don't know.
It smells like burnt hot dogs and KY jelly.
Thanks, Marcus.
I was actually watching a documentary on the thing, right? It turns out they used a lot of KY jelly and all the special effects, which you wouldn't normally think of, right?
But Marcus, actually, I am covered in horse goo.
Right. Just go inside, love. Wash up and tend to horse. So... Horse, you eating a good hay lately? Nice. What are you looking at, Horse? Well, you're not ensanguinated yet, brother.
Oh my whatever. God.
Maybe there's some epidemic going on.
Nick says, good pun. Too bad the commissar is a naysayer. Extinut, Nick.
You probably picked this up at the Saddle Club. You know Miss Crackapple? She has, like, horse diabetes and horse apnea. And so does her horse. Might be mad horse disease or something. I'm sorry, that's worse. Oh. Dad's at least serving you top shelf health care, and let's check your pamper kit. Crutches over. Okay, Horse, we got your brush and perfume, gourmet carrots, and wait, is it just absinthe? What? Is that even allowed?
No.
Okay, whatever Father is doing, he is absolutely not helping. You get absinthe as a cure-all. I get frozen burritos on my bruises and an off-brand alcohol variety pack. How does one even make Veritas off-brand?
Okay, all the horse puns. Oh, God, stop it! Fewer Varilla goes, trot along, Nick. Warden, we're kind of beating a dead horse. Loyal Cav, I heard this horse is from the state of Maine. Jesus!
Why do we put up with this? We are sick and in pain. Hell, you know what these are? These are supposed to be crutches. Because I sprained my ankles and then got them shot with a gun. And despite that, these crutches are indeed just the taped together remains of our stilts. And now he has the gall to force us to sit out here, meters from home, in this ancient barn, in the middle of a horrifying rainstorm. No. Horse, this won't do.
Again, Magnus is the one that winds up causing the Horus Heresy to happen to begin with.
We deserve better. Horse revolution, I say.
Oh, God.
We both shall charge our way into the house. We shall boldly strut into his big room with his big bed and his big couch, and with our shared might, commandeer it for our own, and then demand immediate aspirin, no matter how thin our blood is. What do you say, brother? Will you lead us? Okay, damn it all. Where the fuck is the real medicine? This one? Fuck, no, this is Adderall. No, those are mine. Okay, antipsychotics. No, Dan takes thirst. Okay, no. Got one. Fuck. Okay, just drink this, horse. I really, really do not need you to die right now. You are a ticket to proper pandering.
Is that door?
Okay, fuck. Good. You'll be fine, I think. Right, this medicine should clear you up.
Mm.
Oh, you mind grabbing me the absinthe? Holy shit!
Marcus, help me unload these boars. We won't need to buy American rashers anytime soon.
Door! Knock next time! Horse is trying to sleep.
What? Horse is clearly awake.
No, he's ill with horse plague. Father said so, and he's been forcing us to play midwife to him.
Forcing? The door was not locked when I tried to open it.
Yeah, it's not like he locked us in.
So he wasn't forcing you to stay here?
He was asking forcefully. Fuck, whatever. Just go.
I am going to get the boars out into the freezer. I was hoping you could help me count them. There are many.
What?
How many?
I don't know. Help me count them.
Well, sorry, Dor, but we're planning an insurgency here.
Nice.
What? Come now. It will be just a moment.
I'm not leaving our brother alone. If it was just 1 gallon of blood, I'd go. But this many? Come on, get serious.
He looks to be perfectly not dying at the moment.
Well, then maybe you can call Father out. Maybe he should take some responsibility for a change. Assuming he can count. Didn't sound like it during his so-called math class he put us through in Finland. Remember that?
I remember only the lack of fiends in that cursed land.
He refused to give us the answers to any formula, insisting we need to be able to figure them out ourselves. That was the second time I ended up in crutches. Nothing has changed. It is just one other funny little instance in a long line of painful fuck-ups where we end up suffering as pawns in the little game that is his version of reality.
Marcus.
What, Dor?
Are you all right?
What?
I'm asking if you're all right.
door is showing sympathy. This is unusual.
Yeah, I'm relatively fine. Why wouldn't I be?
Because you don't seem like you are.
Door? I'm okay.
Marcus, please. Just tell me if you aren't.
I'm tired of the mental arithmetic that Father no doubt goes through to justify his actions.
Yeah.
He could have told us specifically what not to do during the interrogation. He could have told us anything at all, in fact, and we could have planned for them. Then, perhaps, my face wouldn't have been planted into the ground like a common turnip by some shitheel. And you know what's worse? He is still not giving us the full scoop on what diablerie even is. He hops around the questions and talks about his new Ipswich ham meat. Why would I care? Just... Horse is just another sterling example of us having to clean up after he acts upon whatever synapse spasms that happen to roil around his brain at any given time. One more poorly justified thing we have to deal with.
Are you unaware of what thoughts go on in Father's brain most of the time? Or any of the time? But I believe he wants what's best for us. And his ultimate goal is to leave us safe. His failings as a parent, I can't condone. But his redaction of information when it comes to hunting the supernatural is needed.
Needed?
Okay.
The few things that Father has confided in me about Blanks has left me truly and utterly afraid.
Huh.
But even when it left me as frightened as a British child, I had valued the insights he had shared with me. We are fighting...
even when he shared... Just like... What the warp is horse sick because some weirdo got him sick door? Probably. Thanks, Pure Tour by Jackson Eagle. Dor just loyal Cav says Dor just keeps on giving me reasons why he's my favorite. Literally, yes. Oh god. The boars, I did not know boars were a problem on the islands. I know they're a huge problem in the Midwest. Basically, there is entire groups like pest control. I didn't even know it was a thing, but apparently farmers will hire people to come out in helicopters with automatic rifles to literally run down boar. Just these massive packs of boar. It's, you can actually look it up on YouTube and watch it. It's crazy to watch, but at the same time, you're just sitting there just... Like, I watched one video one time where they were flying through, and they literally had a counter of how many boar that they killed. And they're not going down and picking up the carcasses and taking them off and processing them. They're just killing them. And they were up to like 120. It was insane. Thanks, Slacker. What if Hawk Boy survived the duel with Horus? It would have meant that he'd have to kill Horus. The Horus heresy would have ended. Big E, the Emperor would have never been able, he would have never, wound up on the Golden Throne. Everything would have really turned out massively different. I do think one or two other Primarchs would have been purged. And I'm not quite sure, like, offhand who those would be. Thanks, Slacker. Niju Machamp. Glad you caught this one. Been busy lately. You should check out Don't Go by Vox in the Void. True Emotion. Vox in the Void? He was actually in the live stream earlier today. I didn't know he put out something new. I'll check that out. I will. I appreciate it, guys. I really do. Can horse dab? Richard Johnson, these bastards breed faster than rabbits, and the males are practically inedible due to how much testosterone they have. Hi, Iron. And that meat could feed, all that meat could feed a lot of people. Yeah, well, there's a problem, and, Richard said it best. The males, basically, if you turn a pig loose in the wild, it'll become a boar. It, like, mutates or some crap like that. I don't get it. Boars are an incredible problem. I'm a hunter, so I don't like killing and wasting, but in certain cases, boar included, I can very much condone it. I understand that. The hospital and I are actually looking this when this hunting season comes up. We're looking to find somebody that is selling venison because we want to diversify that diet a little bit. A grown boar is about the size of an adult motorcycle. They are dangerous. That is true. Boar are huge. Dark Innovator says, the lion would likely be kept around by the Emperor. The guy was spoken to like he was a custodian by the Emperor. Yes, the lion knew a lot of stuff that not a lot of the other Primarchs knew. In fact, the only Primarch that was probably more informed than the lion was Altharius. And Ronnie says, if Sanguinius survived, he would probably be an active Primarch, a very active Primarch, or he would have just disappeared at some point like the others. Boars are a problem all over New Zealand and Australia. It's just, yeah, boars are everywhere, and they're just an invasive species. Okay, here we go.
Against creatures that want to seek us out and kill us. Father has to deal with that fact every time any of us go out for a hunt. Now imagine that fear. But not only apply to our hunts, but every waking moment. I reckon the risk of someone like Camilla, the first vampire, finding out where we live would increase by 400% should we know what he knows.
What?
Even now, at this very moment, we cannot know if someone might, in truth, be listening.
Nobody at all. None of us.
I do not ask that you forgive Father. But I ask that you rekindle your trust in him, Marcus. I believe very, very deep down that he cares more for us than we may ever know.
That's all well and good, Dor, but I can hardly appreciate it when it's buried so deep that I never really see it. He might have good intentions, but if he can't trust me, then I can't trust him.
Then don't trust him, Marcus. In the end, the greatest risk is not external. It is us breaking apart from the inside. So, instead of putting your trust in him, put your faith in us.
Mm-hmm.
As a family.
I can try to do that.
Good.
Dor being reasonable is actually kind of frightening.
I'm glad, Marcus.
Yeah, I said try to get your bloody hopes too far up.
If you would want, I can watch horse if you would wake boy and have him help move the boar corpses into the freezer.
Sure, Dor. You just got back.
Be fine, Marcus. Go inside and rest your shot legs.
Yeah, okay. Thanks, Dor.
No problem at all. You would do the same for me, brother. You will feel better, horse. Just give it time. Would you like me to tell you about my day? Well, I awoke at 7:30 a.m. Okay. Eastern Standard Time. The only correct time. From there, I began my day in preparation for the boar hunt. I began by cleaning my hunting rifle and fletching my bolts. After preparations were complete, I took the car westward to the Forest of Dean. It took 4 hours and 6 minutes until I arrived. From there, I waited for some time. Let my senses sense the sounds and sights of the wilderness.
Dorn is sleepy.
It was quite some time until I saw a hog, so I just waited for the majority of the day. Until I saw one at 6:35 p.m. I waited for it to... Wait for it to get closer.
And here comes Kitten.
Hello,
come back.
Did he change his hoodie?
Door? Oi. Hello? Door? Okay.
God save the Queen!
God bless the United States.
That always works. Oh, must have been a long day.
Mm.
Oh. Fuck.
Yes, what?
Oh.
What is it?
Hello.
Yes, what is it?
Fell asleep, Gov.
So it would seem. I appreciate the awakenment, Captain.
Captain?
Yes.
Why Captain?
Marcus told me you received the formal rank of Captain.
They keep doing this shit. I love all the TTS references so far.
During your time in the military, while I've no respect for lobster backs, I recognize your prowess in the field. I would think twice before engaging you in close quarters.
Okay, so that was actually a funny joke in our TFC clan. Oh shit, horse's medicine! Okay, there you go. Okay. Good, horsey. Good. So Dee told me that horse apparently likes stories?
Affirmative, Captain.
Okay.
Father read to him quite a lot when he was a foal.
You're lying,
having
you hear
stories
read
to us is one of our favorite shared pastimes.
A bit odd for a horse, but if Dee says so.
His brain is colossal. Do not underestimate him. Now, please, tell us a story. Preferably one including a CQC encounter.
Sure, Gov. I guess I could tell you the story from before Marcus and you lot came back around.
Thank you guys for filling in that little memory hole for me. TFC is Team Fortress Classic. I didn't know that existed.
I'm keen to hear your feats of Arthurian heroism.
Right, so, honestly, not sure how much either of you know since I haven't really talked about myself with anyone but Marcus and Dee, but I was born here in Norfolk. I have had parents here as well,
okay.
That part you might know.
Mm.
I have four siblings, brothers, one sister.
Okay.
This is not going as I planned, but it's too late now. I knew that vampires existed before Marcus and Sir Dee came back to Norfolk.
Mm.
I had met one at university.
Mm.
A student by the name of Edwin Davies.
Uh-huh.
He was actually pretty well known around the campus. Everyone kind of went to him for money troubles, and his family seemed well off.
Jackson says, "Fab studies are canon in this timeline." But who's the sister? Who's the sister in this whole makeup? Iron horse burst out of Sir D's head like Athena. Oh my god. Yeah, Diclonius, no one remembers the original Team Fortress. I remember some of the concept art for Team Fortress 2 before it became what it was. And it was absolutely boring. Nick asks, is Conrad a ghoul in this world? I don't think so.
That was until I found Sarah, another student, held up in her loft with him. He was feeding on her while she was asleep, and there was a lot of blood. He had cut her open and was eating her organs.
Absolutely foul. You should not have had to see such a thing.
Yeah, that's appreciated, Dor. So, I got his attention by yelling at him. Something like, "Oi, what are you doing?" And he didn't like that at all, so he stepped away from her and looked at me and... fuck me, I was terrified. He had this look on him, like this look. Anyway, I saw him. His teeth, his fangs. I could see it all. And I couldn't move, but it was different from what Kevin did to us. He took one step towards and just started to ramble about his disdain for having to feed like that on people. Like he was trying to excuse his behavior. Then I remember he was a few centimeters away from me and I could smell the iron on his breath, and then he just looked at me, into me, and then I saw the knife. But I hit him first. Sarah always had a bat by her door. She was smart like that. And, you know, he wasn't expecting it. But now he was pissed, and I just started to throw things at him. Dirty washing, a lamp, a coffee mug, whatever.
I'm taking bets on Bruja for this vampire.
He lunged at me. He tackled me out into the hall. I was freaking out. I totally lost my cool. I was flailing, kicking to get him off. He wasn't doing much better, honestly. He was screaming at me about his fucking suit. It was covered in coffee and cream.
Okay, not Bruja.
He just kept yelling about the coffee. Never mind the bloodstains. After that, I don't remember much. Just fight or flight at that point. I think we got up. I remember stabbing pain in my sight. In the confusion, we'd meandered from the floor to the hallway window, and eventually I kicked him. Really, really, really hard for once. He went through it. There's an iron fence outside the apartments. He got impaled. The sun didn't rise, but I saw him just fade away. Then some more things happened that I don't want to talk about right now. And after a pretty long time, Sir D came back with everyone, you two included.
Okay, so Warden said that it's probably a Najaraja, a clan that needs to eat flesh to feed, not just drink the blood. Didn't know that. Richard says the fact that Kittens was able to fight back probably means he was a thin blood. And yeah, that seems kind of odd that he'd be able to fight back against a vampire as a regular human. So I believe it.
D really helped put some things into context. Gave me some closure. And that helped, truly. It did. It helped me know that it wasn't a person that killed and ate Sarah, I guess. But something else. Something wearing Edwin Davis' skin. I don't really know what that means for me, though. I genuinely liked the bloke. Even up until the last second. Was that too much of a serious story?
Yes.
I'm sorry. Cool. Oh.
Right. Wait a minute. Did he say Sigismund in his sleep?
I reckon you've heard far worse stories told at bedtime, huh? I'll just be quiet now. Marcus?
Hey, can you come inside and help me? I can't get in the shower by myself because of the cast.
Oh boy, alright. Dor fell asleep while watching horse. Should I just leave him, or...?
Ask boy if he can cover for you. He should be almost yes. Using the boar body's back winter breezer.
Wait, by himself?
It's a...
For whatever reason, this reminds me of... They put the master thief in the soda!
Pot of beef, what can I pay?
Alright, I'll be there in a beckon. Right, well... I'll see you later, I suppose, horse. You seem to be doing a lot better, so I feel alright about leaving you with Dor. Yell if you need anything!
Oh god, look at his sleeves.
Thank you.
Uncle Long said that he was gonna go in and that I should come in and. Sorry, Dad. And Uncle Horse, of course. Are you feeling any better, Uncle Horse?
This is literally going to be the best part of the whole thing. Like, boy is my spirit animal for this series right now. He is literally my spirit animal. Thanks, Slacker. Makes sense Siggy traumatized many traitorous starters. He didn't traumatize them. He put them in trauma. Alright, so, yeah, Ronnie says, boy killed a vampire, he can watch a horse. Thank you, Slacker. Let's see, Uncle Horse. I saw a comment by Declonius. The reason all these vamps are so different is because the third generation ate the second generation and pissed off Papa Cain. And Cain's the father of all vampires. He cursed them all differently. The first Nosferatu looked like Fulgrim. That I did not know. He gave them blunt force trauma. Fox says, I kind of want to reread Dark Tower now. Is that a book series? Yukari is my spirit animal from Iron Kiko. Content Leech says, I want to see a wholesome fan art of Boy and Ephriel Stern working out some, just because they share the same voice actor. Strygen says, Boy's going to need the absence letter. All right. I know this is going to be my favorite part. It involves Boy. It's going to be horrific.
Wow. You're really soft. Grampy must have put extra conditioner in your soaps water. Oh, gosh. It's really watery out. Like Yarmouth Golf Adventure Golf Hill.
What?
You know what? I should let Dad sleep, I think. He can sleep through it right now. He looks comfy. If you don't mind him staying in your house, Uncle Horse. I don't know what that means. It is a really nice house, though. It's cozy, nice lamps, and I like the wall paintings.
Paintings?
Is that? Oh, no. Is this
okay.
Your... blood? Oh, Hells, that's a lot. I'm sorry for the swear word.
No.
Let me just fix your blanket. Must have fell off when you were drinking your... Wait, is this... absinthe? Bottoms up!
What? Oh, shit! Boy's getting crunk! Yes.
Anyways,
if you do not know what absinthe is, all right. In the States, we don't really have absinthe. Absinthe is extremely powerful, and I mean stupidly powerful. And if you're in a government position in the United States, you go over and drink absinthe and take a drug test when you get home, you will be fired. Because absinthe, as far as I'm aware, and I may be wrong about this because I'm speaking on information that I got, like, legitimately a while, like, I'm talking a decade or almost, damn, I am an old bastard. 18 years ago, it has wormwood and a couple other things that will set off triggers for LSD. So, let's roll.
There you go. Your blanket will make you extra comfy.
Oh, God.
It's lots of blood you coughed. Way lots. And it almost looks like our house. Funny. Can kind of see the uncles with Grampy. And Dad there. I'll try and find some water to clean it up.
No.
Oh no! What happened?
Is that ghost?
What?
Yes!
C8. Oracle. Gaze into my crimson miasma. Thine Vader laid bare, desiccated on the rocks. By thy hand, the abbot will know.
What the fucking hell? It's heresy time! Slacker, thank you. Slacker prefers whiskey and sake. Okay, so, oh god, I got it. Let's go, let's go. The horse is getting bigger!
The third eye opens. His sweat will feed and warm her gullet. The abbot will know the patriarch in mastering Luna ends hamstrung. He will wish death upon his flesh. But no mercy shall be given, for none he hath gave. The rising tree shall signal war's end. War and triumph, the abbot will know from them. Bloodshed, Armageddon for all. Kind kindred. Daru, Milklings, Elohim, in the light, they all will.
Oh, boy. What the fucking hell was that? I'm scarred for life. I need an adult! Jesus Christ! Thank you, Slacker. We need Sigismund to kill Horse ASAP! Oh my god. Oh, good god, that was fucking horrifying. This is why you don't drink the goddamn absinthe. Horace is voiced by the same voice actor for Horace in TTS. I need an adult. X in the chat, we all need an adult. Oh, God. Oh, my God. Iron Kiko, thank you, bud. I see some heresy. As soon as he drunk the absinthe, and I knew shit was about to get real. I appreciate it, Hunter. Oh, God. Shane says, you're scared. What about boy? Boy's a transplant from the 41st millennium. I don't think much is going to terrify him. Horse was warning about the rise of the third generation in the final night. Okay, so... Now, I'm outdated on this, so Warden says, hey, if boy equals Sigismund, does horse equal Euphrates Keeler? That's absolutely terrifying. Oh, God. Jackson, no. Jackson says Big D is going to face off against horse aboard his ship, the Vengeful Spirit. Referencing the 2002 movie. Jackson, that was the worst one yet. And you should feel ashamed of yourself. Oh my god, okay, I'm hitting play. Oh my god, that was awesome.
Restoring the dead boars.
Horse!
Boring. No sounds over 90 decibels outside of combat.
Horse! Horse! Combat a horse!
Oh, sorry. So, the prophecy... the prophecy is, I believe it was Gehenna, I think it was Gehenna, but All of the third generation are asleep. The initial vampires that the vampire clans are named after, the remaining ones of those. And when Gehenna comes, they're going to awake and wipe out everything. That's the prophecy.
Good to see you're up and about. Are you feeling better?
We the horse. Talked.
Come now, boy. It is almost 12 a.m. Eastern Standard. Well past your bedtime. I will return once I have put boy to bed, horse. Did you drink absinthe again, boy? That's good. No stiff drinks before bed, young man. Oh, but look. It stopped raining. Now we get to enjoy the smell of wet forest. Maybe we'll see a rainbow tomorrow.
Maybe. Oh, poor boy. Thanks, Iron Kiko. Iron Kiko says, don't drink alcohol, kids. This happens, if you will, 100 out of 10. It will. Very true. Let's go. Just say no to absinthe.
Fare thee well, my nephew.
That wasn't a fever dream.
You have listened to an audio drama by Ogre Popinang, with voice work by Speaker D as Big D, Thunder Psyker as Kitten,
Zagran
as Marcus, Super Anchors as Door, Nostalgia as Boy, and Key McKenzie as Horse. Background art by Inktooth, and avatar art by Rude Rubicante, Offhawker, Eliphas, and Garrett. Soundtrack by Macker. Sound composition by Carl the Deranged. Mixing by Stringstorm. Animation by Carl the Deranged.
Yes.
Video composition by
Alfabusa.
With lead writers Blessed. Wait. Blessed. hang on. Blessed wrote this? What? How? But he's the funny guy we always credit as a joke. What? That's so weird. Well, good job, Blessed. You did good. Anyway, script editing by Alfabusa and Speaker D. Special thanks for this episode is dedicated to Blessed's dog, Lucy.
Duh.
Rest in peace, you good girl.
Oh, God.
Poor.
That makes me sad at the end of this. It's a good puppers. It's a good puppers. Slacker, thank you, bud. I appreciate it. I really do. Would Sigismund get along with Grimaldus? Yes. Well, I don't know. I don't know if Sigismund would get along with Grimaldus. Well, I think he would. Yes, he would. He definitely would. Sigismund had that level of dedication. And that level of... He was on the grim grind, so there you go.
Portions of the materials are the copyrights and trademarks of Paradox Interactive AB and are used with permission. All rights reserved. For more information, please visit worldofdarkness.com. Visit patreon.com/alfabusa for updates every other week.
Yeah,
thank you for listening, and good evening.
Now, Insanity by Carl the Deranged. What?
stuck by his grandma with the crossbow and pushed out of luck. The shadow of the frame was blocking out the sun. The boy heard the click as she loaded her gun. The old maternal corpse, she shot but she missed. The boy threw a rock and the boy was pissed. He leapt over her corpse, but she grabbed at his leg. The booty was dragged off in the strike from the dead. Oh yeah.
That mask is freaky.
Your grandma comes for you. Will you scream? Will you cry? Will you tell you will die? What will you do when your grandma comes for you? Kick and bite. Grandma comes tonight.
Yeah. That is so creepy.
And plans. It all seemed too bleak when he came to a creek. The water was deep and he started to swim. Behind him he heard grandma's howling. He made it across and looked at his grandma. She could not float. She was building a boat.
Ronnie, why are you asking why he's not wearing shoes? There's so much other things wrong with him. Oh my god. It's Carl. It's Carl, guys. It is Carl, okay? Alright. Let me scroll up here. Okay. This is some real Stanley Parable bullshit. Strigen says, I want horses, Uncle. True homeboy spread the gospel. Some Krieger says, F in the chat for Lucy. That just makes me sad. Strigen says, the damn ninjas snuck in. Why didn't horse run warn us of the ultra sad? Grimaldus is Sigma, but Sigismund is Sigma. Is Sigma. Okay. That was bad. Oh, why am I? Oh, God. What's with the puns tonight? Vulcan is an eldritch god disguised as a dino chicken nucky. Oh, God. Yeah, me and the hospital were trying to get the chickens out of her house. We really are. Jackson Easel says, I knew that story from the last audio drama was important. I called it. C4TV says, seriously, what is this guy on? Let's see. You have something you want to share with the class, Mr. Reich? You feel the... Oh, wow. Lone Guardsman says, Biggie, deranged ex-cook, everyone. let's see. C4TV says, I'm glad Alfabusa gave Carl so much to do. I shudder to think of what he'd do otherwise. Stycloneus, stop! Okay. So, I'm going to get ready to wrap this up. And then I have work to do on the final part of the three-part series for Five-ish Minute Lore's Bromance, which is Alexis Pollux and Barbarous D'Antioch. Mr. Reich says, Carl is a warp storm and it fries my brain. Hobbit says, Carl is the manifestation of Zeech. Yes. Dark Innovator says, Here's my idea for Leman of the Lion and Hunter. Russell and Lionel. Oh. Carl is Malal? It wouldn't surprise me. It'd be the one time the Malal's been canon in a long time. Anyhow, thank everybody for coming in. I hope you had a good time. I know I did. Well, it's about time for me to get down to basically recording and editing. And, yeah. The next time Alfabusa posts something out, I'll be trying to do another live stream. I'll be doing another live stream as soon as... look for the live streams to happen on the weekends where I can try to schedule, you know, 2 days of live streams as far as All Guardsman Party goes. I'm trying to order my thoughts. My thoughts are kind of jumbled in my head right now, and it's kind of hard to basically get started talking and be coherent right now. And it's because I got a lot of stuff going through my brain, as well as all the ridiculousness. Iron Kiko says, I'm getting a drink, type 5, to join me. Alright. We already know that Carl is canonically this devil in the series thanks to Piotr. okay, so Hobbit, you're out. Alright. You had to get up early in the morning. Thank you. Thank you for joining me, and you guys have a great, if you're going to, like, you're going to work like me tomorrow, I hope you guys have a great week, okay? And I'll be putting out stuff throughout the week. It'll be released in the morning, so, yeah. All that being said, All Guardsman Party, I'm going to continue to watch, I'm going to continue to put out reactions, and I'm going to continue to work on projects. Thank you guys for joining me, and I hope you have a great day, okay? And have a good week. And I'm going to start pressing buttons now. I'm going to press this.